Oh, it's Go Cheeks back with another banger video, and in today's upload, I am on the case because we are talking all about Caitlyn, the Sheriff of Piltover. We will be covering her passive, her abilities, tips and tricks, combos, builds, runes, skill order, in other words, everything you need to master this champion. So it's time to channel the FSN Sable within you and get into this ultimate Caitlyn guide. And if you do find it useful, give that like button a hit and also hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our daily videos. So let's start by talking about Caitlyn's identity. So Caitlyn is a high range AD carry and has the highest base auto attack range out of any champion in the entire game, so we have to use this to our advantage. So it is a must to get in a practice tool so you can get used to this range. So if you go to your settings, then interface, click on show attack range and get familiar with it. The best Caitlyns in the world are very hard to kill and play against just because they abuse the extra range they have. Now, one thing they also do is they play Caitlyn how she should be played, as a pokey lane bully. There is nothing more annoying than playing against a Caitlyn who perma harasses you when you go to last hit. So in terms of playing the laning phase, you should always be looking to push the minion wave into the enemy tower so you can poke as much as possible. Now let's get into Caitlyn's passive and her abilities. So her passive, headshot. This is one of the key subjects in this video, so listen up. So when you auto attack a target on Caitlyn, you generate a stack of headshot. You can see this above my HUD, and when you get to 6 stacks, your next attack is indeed going to be that headshot, which is going to deal extra damage to that target, and this damage scales with your level and crit. Now this stacking, however, is doubled when you attack from a brush. So each auto attack here is giving me 2 stacks. Now because of this, instead of getting to 6 stacks and proccing headshot, we only need to get to 5 stacks when in a brush and bang, headshot. But let's say you can't be bothered counting your stacks above your HUD. Well, there are 2 other ways to know if you have a headshot ready. The first, Caitlyn's rifle will almost sparkle, and the second, you will hear this sound. Now, some other important details. To clarify, you can no longer cancel your auto attack animation with headshots. So before, you could auto attack and then headshot instantly, no longer a thing. Now, once you skill your W and E, which we will detail shortly, when an enemy champion is hit by either of these 2 abilities, they instantly trigger your headshot and you will see a bunch of arrows pointing towards that target and this range indicator behind them. And the range, by the way, at which you can attack these champions is doubled. Now, when you auto attack wards or blast cones or scryer's blooms, your headshot does not get used. It only procs on targets with health. So turrets, inhibs, jungle monsters, minions, but it does deal less damage to anything that isn't a champion. But perhaps the most important tip in regards to your passive is to use it to pressure your opponents during the laning phase. When you have that headshot auto attack ready, you are at your strongest. So look to use that range even more when you see that rifle sparkle. Now for your abilities. So your Q is called Piltover Peacemaker, and this ability you are maxing first, and it's critical to use well before the late game because it's a big source of your damage. So when you press Q, you fire a shot where your cursor is, and this deals physical damage to targets it passes through, but less damage to those hit after the first, so like a ZQ. So it's always a good idea to use your Q when there is nothing in between you and an enemy champion. So if your support goes in and there is a minion in front of you, move to the side and Q so you maximize that damage. But fun fact, if a champion steps on a trap and you Q them, it doesn't matter if there are minions in the way because they will still cop the maximum damage. Now it has the same range as your headshot attack, which is a lot of range, and is a great tool to get the push in the laning phase because you can simply Q an entire minion wave when it's waddling into your lane and you insta gain that minion advantage. Now a couple more things, your Q is pretty telegraphed, so it takes a bit of time to channel and travel, so enemy champions who are mobile should really be dodging most of them. So to increase your chances of landing your Q, wait until that target goes for a last hit. Wait until your support lands a bit of CC. Wait until you can slow them with your E before queuing. Try to last hit a minion with your Q while aiming it at an opponent. And Q flash, this is not legit. So this dummy that is out of range is still out of range when I Q flash. Now your W, your auto snap trap, and we are maxing this second. So when you press W, you place a trap where your cursor is, and after 1 second, this trap is then armed. So when an enemy champion walks over it, they get rooted for 1.5 seconds, revealed, and they also trigger your headshot attack that will actually deal even more damage. Now these traps on the ground last for 30 to 50 seconds, and you can place 3 to 5 traps depending on the points in your W, and your traps do have a recharge time that decreases the more points in your YST. So in the early game, it is super important not to just use your traps like they're going out of fashion. They are a great attacking threat, but also a great defensive tool. So place a trap when your Blitzcrank lands a hook, almost a guaranteed kill. Place a trap where you are running to safety so that Darius can't chase you down. So always save 1 trap in case a fight breaks out because you are a much scarier champion with a trap in hand. And when you place more traps down than you're actually allowed to on the battlefield, the first trap you put down will just get removed and replaced by the new one. Now, the range of your W is actually bigger than your auto attack range. So even if a target is outside of your attack range, you can still pressure them with your traps. Now, your traps do grant sight of a small area for 1 second. So if you think the enemy jungler or assassin or support might be camping in a nearby brush, trap the brush. But notice how the trap doesn't actually reveal the entire brush. It's only a small portion of it. So an enemy champion could still be in that brush. So do be careful. Now, using your traps to influence enemy champions' movement is something the best Kates do on the wreck. So two common examples here. Example 1, place trap just below enemy to push them up into a queue. Example 2, place trap just above enemy so they move down towards your support sitting in a bottom brush. So manipulating the enemy champion's movement with where you place your traps is a great idea. Now if you can, don't just walk around pressing W while doing nothing else. The best Caitlyn's will place traps as part of their other animations, whether that be auto-attacking or using other abilities, and we'll show you how to do this very soon. Now your traps are an amazing counter to any sort of telegraphed interaction, whether it's a teleport, and with teleport that champion is always going to appear towards their nexus, so you should always trap in that direction. Whether it's Sonya's hourglass or someone respawning from Guardian's Angel or Yone-Z, it's just a big cut. Now one final tip that is really helpful: when you are pressuring the enemy bot lane under their tower, you can hide your traps around the back of the towers and they become pretty much impossible to see. This catches out even the best players. Now the last of your basic abilities, we have your E, the 90 caliber net, and even though you are maxing this last, it is still a very big ability in your kit. So when you press E, you fire a net in the target direction, which propels you in the opposite direction. Now this deals magic damage, which yeah, no one cares about, because what we do care about here is the fact it slows that target and procs your headshot. Now the range is exactly the same as your trap range, so if you place a W on a target, you can E that target as well for multiple headshots. But the real key to using your E is not actually using it. Sounds weird, but in lane, you are only using your net to one shot an enemy champion with your headshots or to escape and engage. Now, you can use it to get back to lane faster out of base, but you don't want to use it more than twice, otherwise you will be before you can say evidence. Now, each time you use your net, you want to be using some sort of combo, which we'll get into shortly. The reason for this is because you can cast any of your abilities while dashing, including your ultimate, as you can see. And I know we haven't talked about how your E works with Flash, that's because it is in the combo chapter of this video, which is just around the corner. Now, your last ability is, of course, your ultimate ace in the hole. So Caitlyn channels for 1 second and then fires a big ass bullet at the targeted champion. Now while doing so, that enemy is revealed, so you might even want to use this before an enemy champion runs into a brush, so your teammate who's chasing them can keep damaging them. But Caitlyn is also revealed, so against assassins this could be risky to use because you give away your position. So champions like Kha'Zix, Evelynn, Shaco, these champions might be able to capitalize. Now this ace in the hole deals a ton of physical damage, but other enemy champions can actually intercept it. So if there are 5 enemy champions grouped together, one of them may be really low, but using your ulti is probably going to be a waste unless all of them are extremely low HP. Exactly the same with the laning phase. It's definitely not worth to ult an opponent if they are healthier than half HP. But if both the enemy ADC and support are around 25% HP, let's say, give it a crack. Just because you don't kill them doesn't mean you cannot create a massive gold lead after they recall. Now the range is huge on this thing and stays the same at each rank, and also reveals the area traveling over, similar to an Ashe Hawkshot. Now one cool trick is that you don't actually have to click on that champion on your screen if you want to ult them. Like sometimes they might be so far away and you'll just CBF about moving your camera, so what you can do is click on that character's icon on the minimap and your ulti will be sent. But the only issue with this is that you really should be looking to see how low that champion is before pressing R. So your camera will probably be on that target anyway, so you can just click on them. Now, Ace in the Hole will go on a 5-second cooldown if Caitlyn's channel is actually interrupted. So it might be from a knockup, a silence. The target might even become untargetable, like Fizz with his playful trickster, or a champion using their stopwatch. And of course, if Caitlyn flashes or dies. Now, if the targeted champion dies while your ultimate is traveling, it will still hit that champion's corpse and can still be intercepted by other champs. Now, let's get into the fun part of the video and talk about the combos you need to master on Caitlyn. So first up, we have the very standard EQ combo. So you're EQing and then auto attacking with the headshot from your net. Now this is the most basic combo and probably the one you will use the most. You can use it on CC'd enemies, champions who are up close and personal. It's just a great way to deal damage in the early game because you're landing Q and also making use of a headshot. Now one good tip is to actually slightly delay your Q because the enemy will most of the time know this is coming, so they will instantly juke. After they juke is when you Q. So this combo just involves an auto attack before you Q. Now next up we have the angled EQ. So EQing at a different angle. This would be be ideal if the enemy support is close to you, but you want to damage the enemy AD carry. So you could either support and flick your mouse to the main target and then press Q. You can also use this to chase enemies and hide your Q. So simply E behind you, flick your mouse to the enemy and press Q immediately. Now next up we have the attacking EW combo. Exactly the same as the standard EQ combo, but you're pressing W and not Q. But the target location has to be within your trap's radius, and another good tip, just like the previous combo, is to wait just a tiny bit before pressing your W. So instead of pressing EW pretty much at the same time, what you're doing is pressing E and just waiting a little bit, and then W. For whatever reason, this is just cleaner. And of course, as part of this combination, you can add your Q to it and your ultimate as well. Now next up, the defensive EW combo. So instead of trapping the target you hit with your net, you're actually trapping behind yourself to discourage enemy champions from chasing you and potentially killing you. Now one of the more complicated but underrated combos is the net flash combo. Because in most situations, you will be fighting multiple enemy champions and danger is always close. So having this in your arsenal is always a good thing. So this is cancelling net with flash, and this allows you to create space as quickly as possible. So you might be getting ganked and you need to get to safety ASAP. Or you can do it when you're fighting an enemy champion to headshot them faster and or to dodge a major skill shot. Or you might do it to execute an enemy champion who is running away. Or because there is another object in the way, like a minion for example. So there are actually lots of applications to this combo. Even though it looks kind of pointless, it's definitely good to get down pat. Now last up we have the Gale Force net combo. So this combo is very similar to using your net with flash, and it's all about shortening your net's animation and then headshotting the target immediately after the Gale Force animation. So you press E and then you're going to wait just a little bit, and then we Gale Force and then auto attack the target coming out of it. And all of these combos as well, of course you can add your Q and your ultimate into it, but just remember guys, that when the late game comes around and you're 2-3 items deep, your damage is really going to come from auto attacking and headshotting. So your Q actually becomes less important the longer the game goes on. But of course you can add your Q and your ultimate to most of these combinations. Now for the final chapter of this guide, we're going to talk about runes, builds, and then summoner spells. So in terms of your runes, you actually have a couple of options as Caitlyn, which is great. So the first one I'm going to recommend to you, probably the most consistent, is with Fleet Footwork. And the reason Fleet is so good on Caitlyn is because you're going to be auto attacking enemy champions a lot, or you should be, you're going to be getting the max value out of the heal and the movement speed as well. Now for the rest of the precision tree, you can see Presence of Mind, so we don't run Oom, and we're also running Bloodline for sustain. Then we're going to run Cut Down in the final tree, because most, if not every champion in the game is going to have more HP than you, especially if you start with a longsword, which we'll get into very soon. Now for your secondary tree, taking Sorcery, with Absolute Focus and Gathering Storm, gives you the power you need when you're healthy during the laning phase, and also gives you the scaling you need with Gathering Storm. Now for your minor runes, they're always going to stay the same. So an Attack Speed Shard, an Adaptive Force Shard, and then we're going to run Armor or Magic Resist depending on the enemy bot lane. But the other page you can think about going is going Lethal Tempo with Inspiration. Now go Lethal Tempo if you know you can auto attack the enemy AD carry and the bot lane in general. So if it's a very short range lane you're against, maybe it's a Vayne with a melee support, you know that you can auto attack these champions more than you can auto attack a Jinx for example. So Lethal Tempo is just going to give you more value in these games. And as for the Inspiration tree, we're taking Footwear because saving 300 gold for a scaling AD carry is great news. And then we're going to take Biscuit Delivery so we can have a bit more power and aggressiveness in the laning phase. We're not going to run Oom. Now as for your items, it's very standard stuff. We're going Gale Force as our mythic because really you need the mobility. Now for your second major item, you really have a few options. You can go Collector if the enemy team is squishy because the lethality is going to allow you to shred squishy enemy champions. But you could consider going Rapid Fire Cannon if you feel as if you need the range against the enemy team composition because they might have a lot of champions who can dive onto your head, or a lot of melee champions, so having the range is crucial. Or you could also take Stormraiser, which is going to give you the self-peel you kind of need. So in solo queue, rarely are you actually going to get your support peeling you. So Stormraiser with the slow is going to be really useful against those champions who might want to jump onto your head. Now as for your third item, you really have two options here. So Infinity Edge is what you can get, especially if you've got a Rapid Fire Cannon as your second major item. But if you didn't get the RFC as your second item, you can always consider this getting this third because the range is just so critical in the current meta. And after these two, you have a ton of options, of course. You can go Lord Dominus of Guards, Guardian's Angel, Bloodthirster, Mortal Reminder, Phantom Dancer, Mercurial Scimitar for the QSS. There are just a bunch of options. It really depends on the enemy team composition you're against and what you actually need to survive and actually deal damage to them. And as for your summoner spells, we are always taking Flash. And you can either run this with Heal, Cleanse, or Exhaust. Now the last one, Exhaust, is going to be really valuable if the enemy team composition has champions like Zed, champions who can deal a lot of damage quickly to you and who might be close range. But the enemy team composition might have like a Lux mid lane, maybe a Morgana support, so something like Cleanse is going to be really good. But to be honest, the most consistent summoner spell you can take apart from your flash is going to be Heal. And what lots of people don't actually understand with Heal is that it's a great offensive summoner spell. So if the enemy champions are running away and they're really low HP, you can use Heal just for the movement speed to catch up to them and actually deal damage. And of course, it's great on the defensive side of things because you're not just affecting yourself. An ally champion is going to benefit from it. So that was our Caitlyn guide for the preseason and season 12. If you did learn or if you did enjoy the video, please let us know by leaving a like down below. Also remember to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our preseason season 12 content. And also make sure to check out the Game Week website on your way out because we have the best challenger players and coaches making daily content for our subscribers. So make sure you get that exclusive access by signing up. And until tomorrow's daily video, guys, this has been the Jizz.